In 1974, the novel was published by Doubleday. One afternoon, I was talking to my priest. I am an Episcopalian. And I happened to mention to him an important scene near the end of the novel in which the character Felix Buckman meets a black stranger at an all-night gas station and they begin to talk. As I described the scene in more and more detail, my priest became progressively more agitated. At last he said, "That is a scene from the book of Acts, from the Bible. In Acts, the person who meets the black man on the road is Philip. Your name." Father Roche was so upset by the resemblance that he could not even locate the scene in his Bible. "Read Acts," he instructed me, "and you'll agree. It's the same down to specific details." I went home and read the scene in Acts. Yes, Father Roche was right. The scene in my novel was obviously retelling of the scene in Acts. And I had never read Acts, I must admit. But again, the puzzle became deeper. In Acts, the high Roman official who arrests and interrogates St. Paul is named Felix, the same name as my character. And my character, Felix Buckman, is a high-ranking police general. In fact, in my novel, he holds the same office as Felix in the book of Acts, the final authority. There's a conversation in my novel which very closely resembles a conversation between Felix and Paul. Well, I decided to try for any further resemblances. The main character in my novel is named Jason. I got an index to the Bible and looked to see if anyone named Jason appears anywhere in the Bible. I couldn't remember any. Well, a man named Jason appears once, and only once in the Bible. It is in the book of Acts. And, as if to plague me further with coincidences, in my novel, Jason is fleeing from the authorities and takes refuge in a person's house. And in Acts, the man named Jason shelters a fugitive from the law in his house. An exact inversion of the situation in my novel, as if the mysterious spirit responsible for all this was having a sort of laugh about the whole thing. Felix, Jason, and the meeting on the road with the black man who is a complete stranger. In Acts, the disciple Philip baptizes the black man, who then goes away rejoicing. In my novel, Felix Buckman reaches out to the black stranger for emotional support because Felix Buckman's sisters just died and he is falling apart psychologically. The black man stirs up Buckman's spirits, and although Buckman does not go away rejoicing, at least his tears have stopped falling. He had been flying home, weeping over the death of his sister, and had to reach out to someone, anyone, even a total stranger. It is an encounter between two strangers on the road, which changes the life of one of them, both in my novel and in Acts. And one final quirk by the mysterious spirit at work, the name Felix is the Latin word for happy, which I didn't know when I wrote the novel. A careful study of my novel shows that for reasons which I cannot even begin to explain, I had managed to retell several of the basic incidents from a particular book of the Bible and even had the right names. What could explain this? That was 4 years ago that I discovered all this. For 4 years I have tried to come up with a theory, and I have not. I doubt if I ever will.